Good morning, beautiful, 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 beautiful soul. I hope you are ready to take on the world, to take on the challenges. I got up this morning, and as a part of my daily devotional, what I read and what has resonated with me all morning is problems won't last forever. You cannot just have to trust that. You know, for a lot of people, yesterday was Valentine's Day, and I would say that it may have been problematic for a lot of you who had not in a relationship or never received a gift or never got caught up in the whole sensational BS, quite frankly. But see, the day done already, we're on to the next day. You may be in a job that you're unhappy. You may be in a relationship that you're not so happy. You may be a certain size that you're uncomfortable. You may look in your account and you don't see as many zeros as you really want. But just trust that nothing lasts forever. You go have your season of good, you go have your season of bad, you go have your season of where it just feels like nothing is moving. But you have to remember, you know, whatever the mind can conceive, the mind can achieve. And sometimes these little things on the internet is not necessarily what you need, you know. You just have to take a radical step to get radical results. Because by sitting and doing the same thing over and over and over and over again, if it's not producing what you want, it means you have to do something different. Because that's really the sign of insanity. So don't just sit down and look at somebody and copy what you see happening on the outside of their life. Really, really break it apart. And if you get the opportunity to sit with them, ask them questions, you know. What is it that makes you most happy? Because sometimes we chase the money, but maybe money is not really what people are after. I think I've said it before on another one of these a couple of days. It's like, it's happiness. It's feeling, this feeling of validation, or sometimes a feeling that you're serving something higher and greater and bigger than who you are. I don't get up every day this high and strong on life, but I'd be damned if I'm gonna sit down and let somebody pour into me something that's gonna make me feel bad or like me can't do it or like me can't achieve it. You know, the only limitations you have are really the ones you set. I remember when I just came back to Jamaica from college, and I said, okay, music is what I wanted to do, and acting, and we started that, and we made so many inroads, and we're still working on that. We have the album coming out this year. We never stopped, but there is a part of me that said, you know what? I wanted to do something else. Real estate was that other thing. I mean, there are other business ventures that we're really trying to work at, but for every time you see a win, there are so many things that didn't work. But I have to say to you too, you know, the things that don't work aren't your failures. You have to make sure, so when you fall forward. So you take the lessons from everything. It may have seemed like you never put a lot of money in your pocket, or it may never blow up like this overnight sensation, or gotten you the attention, or, you know, all of that stuff that so many people are caught up in, you know. It's amazing. Just sit down and look at people and try and figure out why you think they do the things they do. You know, sometimes things just look really good and perfect and pretty on the outside, but you don't have a clue what people do to maintain some of these images, and them go home and bawling at them bed every night. So you have to, and let me take the glasses off and talk to you. You have to find what makes you happy. Surround yourself with the people who feed not just your pocket, because the minute you start spending, you will lose money. But people who feed that part of you that we can't see when we look on you. To feed your soul, feed your mind. You know, I go back to even relationships. So many, and I'm going to talk to my sisters on this one. So many people, we flash this, oh, I'm this independent woman card, and we don't need no man for this. And when you really break it down, a lot of you are unhappy and lonely. And when you sit and you really break it down, maybe somebody hurt you, but maybe that next person that's waiting to get into your life to pour into you, need you to pour into them. So we have to fix the brokenness and the pretense and stop being fake and stop being a superstar in somebody else's version of what your happiness needs to look like, because that not gonna get you nowhere. It absolutely not gonna get you nowhere. You're losing days, you're losing time, you're losing years. You don't wanna get there 10 years from now and come back and say, yo, man, if only I did this. So for today, I'm just telling you, instead of you know, the perpetual pain and the constant complaining, let's just praise God for all of the good things that are happening in your life. I mean, just choose to be happy. Choose to be happy. I'm gonna try to do more of these a couple of days. I hope you've all gone over to www.shireentv.com. So much is coming. So much is coming. I want you to subscribe. That's all I can say. The music never stopped because a singer never stops singing. But we have to live to give you something. I'm not interested in being all over Instagram and Facebook and at every event and show up at every party so people can ask me the same. So what you gonna do in the next 5 years? My brain needs to be stimulated beyond that. I wanna do stuff that when I'm done, it leaves such an impact that long after me gone, I've created businesses and you know, with rock, the charity, or with this real estate business, or with music, such a legacy that other people can benefit from what we do. If all you're doing is to put money in your pocket while you're alive, when you're dead, it's dead with you. So I want to live a life that's bigger and greater and more purposeful and more impactful, and not walking around in these little, I don't know, not these little boring boxes to me that people think are so important, or being a part of certain social groups that people think are so important. And the minute you lose the car and the minute you lose the house, then you're no longer in this group or you're no longer cool. I'm not about that life. I'm not about that life. It's about black excellence. It's about that black girl sauce. It's about just getting up and doing good. And it's not just limited to women. So be great today. Be awesome.